click subscribe and bell icon to get regular notifications.
Family history or genetic disease is only one of the risk factor in cancer generation. Only 1 to 3% of the cancer, or maybe 1 to 5% of the cancer which runs in the family, or which are we can say it as having family history positivity or hereditary cancers. When we call it is hereditary cancer is when there are more than 3 family members, and in more than 2 generations of the family are there in any family, then probably the next generation will have more incidence of cancer patients. So in that particular family, you will be little more prone to develop cancer. So all those members in the family should be little vigilant and observe themselves, have a healthy lifestyle, and very important, please do screening regularly. And there are some genetic tests available which we can do. Now, what is the role of mutations? Mutations is simply, I can say it as there is a defect in the gene. That means we know the genes are the sequences of DNAs and RNAs in every cell. And whenever there is some mismatch somewhere, some defect somewhere, some enzyme deficiency somewhere, that is called as mutations. So these mutations could be sporadic or could be hereditary. So when it happens, when it runs through the family, like for example BRCA1, BRCA2 genes for breast cancer, then sometimes the NMIG gene or MTC, medullary carcinoma thyroid gene, or the intestinal cancer, that is FFE, familial adenosis polyposis gene. So if these genes are running in the family, definitely the next generation will be at high risk. There are 2 types of genes. One is oncogene, which will cause cancer, and second is tumor suppressor gene, that will keep the tumor under control. So that will suppress the cancer growth. So any mismatch, any imbalance between these genes will cause the cancer, which will be genetic related cancers. So what we should do? Are the genetic tests available? Whom should we should advise the genetic test? So as I told, if any particular family has been prone with this kind of hereditary cancers, definitely there are gene assays available. Now there are genetic signatures available, and when any patient or any family has those kind of exposure prior to the genes, we can do those genetic tests. We can do the research or analysis of your particular family gene. We can predict that in your family probably the next generation will have going to be a problem, and we can allow you to be little more vigilant, more little more cautious about your own health. And there are some treatment available so that you can prevent even if you are genetically prone. For example, for BRCA1, BRCA2, we can do prophylactic mastectomies. For thyroid cancer gene positivity, we can do prophylactic thyroidectomies. Or there are medicines which can prevent those cancer progression. So in a nutshell, yes, the genes are one of the risk factors. Genetic predisposition can cause cancer, but it should be triggered by environmental factor. And for family history positive patient, we should get our genetic profiling done, genetic test done, not for all patients, only for those 1 to 5% of patients where this particular gene is positive in the family.